Hello everyone. How are you today? My name is Adetokunbo Mike from the Genius FS. I'm here again with another video, another strategy, mobile strategy for scalping. On this episode, I'll be teaching you how to use 3 envelope with MACD and a Bollinger bands with crazy settings. Before anything, let me share with you the settings. You go to your F sign, you click on your F sign. You use 3 envelope. The first one period is 200, deviation is 0.200. Method is simple. You apply to close any color of your choice. Levels. Here is the level. Minus is 0.1, minus is 0.15, minus is 0.2, minus is 0.25, minus is 0.3, like that till is zero. You click done. Second envelope, period is 200, exactly the same. You apply to I. Then there is no level. You click done. Next envelope, period is 200, deviation is 0.200. Method is simple. You apply to low any color of your choice, but make sure the colors are the same thing. No level. Then you click done. Indicator window 1, MACD. Fast EMA 150, slow EMA 151, MACD SMA 1. You apply to close any color of your choice. You click done. Bollinger bands. Period is 105. Deviation is 0.180. You apply to first indicator data. No level. Then you click done. Guys, this is how your chart will look like. This is how your chart will look like. This strategy is a very, very crazy strategy, and it works like a robot, as you can see. Now, let me show you how it works. But before that, let me show you your indicators. Here is your three envelope. Your 3 envelope. Here is your MACD, the one that looks like war. Is your MACD in red color, in red red and ash color. The one in green line is your Bollinger bands. That is your Bollinger bands. Now, anytime there is market inside this envelope, you don't do anything. You allow market to go out of the envelope before you can do anything. I'll show you how to use it to buy and sell in the financial market. You don't do anything if price action is inside the envelope. Let me show you another example. This is another example. You don't do anything if price is inside the envelope. Now, this is how to use it to buy and to sell in the financial market. Firstly, you are going to make sure that your MACD and your Bollinger bands at the indicator window 1 cross each other, I mean from this level. When your MACD cross in between the Bollinger band, the one in green line, then you are going to check your chart. This is around where it happens. I mean it happens around this place, exactly around this place. That is where the crossover occur. But your market is in between. You have to hold on. You wait until you realize that your price action has crossed. If your price action has crossed from inside the envelope outside, that is where you will enter your buy opportunity, yeah, and put your stop loss at the back of this envelope, and you continue to ride your trade. Let me repeat myself. Firstly, your MACD will cross in between the Bollinger bands at the wing at the indicator window one. It will cross. The red line will cross the green line. The red, the ash and red a color line, that's your MACD, will cross the green. That is your Bollinger band. That is your first confirmation. But when they cross, if the market price action has not break this envelope, you do not do anything. You hold on your trade, guys. But by the time you realize that your price action has crossed above the envelope, I mean around this place, that is where you take your buy opportunity and you continue to ride your trade. You put your stop loss at the back of this envelope. Let me show you another sell opportunity. Here is another sell opportunity. This is where crossover occur. The crowd, the MACD cross the green line, that Bollinger band at your indicator window one. Then around where it cross, this is around where it cross. Market is in between, and I told you, if your price action is in between the envelopes, you do not do anything. You allow your price action to break this envelope down. That is when you enter your market. Now look at it. This is your first opportunity. This is your first opportunity, guys. It is a live account, as you can see. It is a live account managing for somebody. Let me show you again. Now look at it. When the crossover occur around this place, that is where you are going to check your price action, where it is. You don't do anything until it breaks. So by the time your price action breaks, guys, you enter your sell opportunity here. You enter your sell opportunity around here. You put your stop loss at the back of this envelope, then you continue to ride your trade, guys. You continue to ride your trade. Let me show you another asset. That's good. I'm showing you pounds, US dollar. Look at it from here. The crossover has already happened from this place. The crossover has happened from this place. The red has crossed the green. I mean the red has crossed the green. Now, where did they cross? This is the area the cross happened. You don't do anything because market is still at the downtrend here. You allow your market to go inside and cross above this envelope. Now look at what happened here. This is what happened. When there is breakout, you enter your buy opportunity, you put your stop loss at the back of this envelope, and you ride on your trade. The overall market is uptrend. Let me show you another sell opportunity. This is another sell opportunity. There is the crossover occur here. This is around where the crossover occur. You don't do anything, you hold on your trade. You hold on your trade. As you can see, trade is in the market. The price action is in between the envelope. Then you wait. When price action breaks, this is where price action breaks. When it breaks, I will enter the market and put my stop loss at the back of this envelope and continue to hold on my trade. As you can see, boom, the move occur. Let me show you another asset. This is another asset. Market breaks through. This is where the crossover occur, and then where the crossover occur, market has already break down. You can enter this one immediately, guys. You enter your sell opportunity where there is crossover already. Put your stop loss here, and you continue to ride, guys. When you enter this trade, you realize that there is a little bit pullback, but it did not hit your stop loss. You continue to hold on your trade, guys. Let me show you another buy opportunity here. Look at where the cross happened. This is where the cross occur. The red cross the green, and then this is where it happens. Your price action is in between. You don't do anything. Around here it breaks. You enter your buy opportunity, you put your stop loss here, and you continue to ride the trade. Now look at how long it is. This is how long the trade is. As you can see, this is how long the trade is. it continues to move. As long as your price action did not cross and break these envelopes towards down, you hold on to your trade. Look at it, market continues. Market continues until this place. Then you continue to sell. Let me show you another asset. This is Pans JPY. Look at it. This is Pans JPY. Yeah, this is a very good example here. The crossover happened around this place. The MACD crossed the Bollinger Bands. Then you check where the cross occurred. This is where the cross occurred. The market has never break through. Then you hold on. Guys, you hold on around this place. You enter your market. You can enter here. It pull back a little bit when your stop loss is here. It did not eat it. It get back up. It come back. It did not eat your stop loss. Then market went forward. Boom. This is the outcome of the entry. Guys, if you know this video has done you good in one way or the other, please like, subscribe, and share my channel to somebody else to benefit. Don't be greedy, guys. Let another person know about this channel, that this channel is a mobile strategy channel whereby we provide strategy for people outside here, most especially beginners, to trade in the financial market. I remain myself, Adetokun Bomai, from the Genius FS. I love you all. Keep winning, guys. All my clients, all my students all around the world, keep winning. Every one of you that traded NFP news with me on Friday, keep winning. I love you all. Thanks.